The purpose of the spike is to drive the ball to the floor on the opponent's court. Generally speaking, it occurs following a set close to the net. Let's see how a spike is done. There are several adequate starting positions. One is to place the right foot forward with full weight over it. The attacker must position himself beyond or at the 3-meter line. He stands erect, reading the setter. The first step forward with the left foot is for orientation or adjustment to the ball. The break step follows successively, positioning the right foot first, then closing with the left foot before the jump. The break step occurs at least 1 meter from the net. The feet are about shoulder width apart at a 45 degree angle to the net. The shoulders and hips are oblique to the net. The right foot hits the floor heel first, while the left foot is positioned in front, closer to the net, on the ball of the foot. Simultaneously to the break step, the arms are brought backwards. The arms are then thrusted forward with the close step. Finally, arms keep moving upward as the legs extend. Let's now look at the body posture in the air before striking the ball. As the player leaves the floor, the body extends and the elbow of the hitting arm is drawn back, while the non-striking hand points upward. The elbow of the hitting hand is above shoulder height. The hand and forearm are turned upward. The shoulders are almost perpendicular to the net, while the legs are bent back. To contact the ball, the hitting arm is thrust forward, assisted by a rotation of the shoulders and a flexion of the upper body. The striking arm is extended in order to make contact with the ball at the highest possible point in front of the body. The body is then in a pike. Just before ball contact, the wrist is snapped. Seen from another angle, we clearly see the hitting arm as the hand caps the ball, giving it a top spin. When landing, the attacker maintains his balance and absorbs the impact by bending the legs. As you look at the whole spike at normal speed, note the rhythm linking the different components of the attack technique. Spiking requires tremendous physical attributes. It should be introduced early in the player's technical development so that he can enjoy volleyball even more.